Chat? Chat, I'm here. Hello, it's me, Wilbur. Ha ha ha. Now chat, my hair. So I don't know if you know, but I say hello, hi everyone, hi. A couple months ago, I said I wasn't gonna be cutting my hair until the new song comes out, my new Lovejoy song. Do you guys remember that? Do you guys remember when I said that? No haircut till the new song, yeah? You all remember? Yeah, okay, cool. So, my hair is looking very silly. And chat, when I step into frame, you have to promise not to make fun of me, okay? You have to promise not to make fun of my haircut, chat, okay? No, don't cry. Don't say, oh dear. You need to be reassuring. You need to say, yes, Will, we won't make fun of you. Promise. Okay, you won't make fun of me? I need to run a poll, mods. No, don't actually. I'll take too long. Just, I need you guys to say. Actually, no, yeah, mods, run a poll. Will you make fun of me, yes or no? I need to hear it. Otherwise, I'm going to stay like this the whole stream. Oh, I'm ill, chat. I'm ill. Can you hear? Oh, I look so hunched like that. If you imagine this is my back, this is my shoulder, chat. But imagine this is my back. I'm like a little hunchback. I'm like a little leaning boy. Come on, are you gonna make fun of me or not? Wait, can I lean to turn my radiator off, or is it gonna show? Oh, that will show. I can't do that. Okay, will you make fun of Will's hair? Let's see what they've said. You gotta say no, or I'm hiding. Okay, 63% no so far. I was leaning on no. Okay. Someone just said they've been ill for so long. Okay, do you remember when I did that show and I got ill in October? I haven't felt like 100% better since. I've just been... It's like I'm broken. I'll tell you about it in a bit. 71. Okay. Okay, chat. Okay, you're gonna not make fun of my hair, okay? Yes, my hair. Forehead check. Okay. Look at that. Forehead. God damn, boy. That's goofy as fuck. What? It's my hair. Get over it, man. Anyway, hi, chat. How's it going, chat? Look, I've told you, when my new song comes out, I'll get a fucking haircut, all right? No, stop talking about fucking wigs. It's not funny, it's not nice. You're being mean to me, okay? You're being mean to me. I will get a haircut when the song is out. That's in literally a week, okay? I'll get a fucking haircut then. Tell you what, I'll stream it. Huh? Do you want me to stream? Get me getting a haircut? Do you want a haircut stream? Because I'll do it. You're like my grandma, yeah? And you're fucking dumb, and I hate you. Are you bald now, hence the wig? No, this is not a wig. Sarah the Lost, thank you for the 25. This is just my hair, chat. I wish you guys could let me live. You know, like, can't a guy grow some follicles without people being like, oh, it's a wig. But look how red my lip is from fucking just blowing my nose all day. I'm not a well-looking boy, and that's not because of the haircut. Not another bald streamer. Chat, I'm not bald. You can see my hair, chat. What are you talking about? You can see my hair on my head. How am I bald? Not in this lifetime, you 2004 looking motherfucker. You promised you wouldn't be mean to me. Chat, we made a deal. Hold on, I need to lower my chair so I look more pathetic. Hold on. There we go. You promised you wouldn't be mean to me. Chat. You said you'd be nice. Now look where we are, huh? You're making fools out of yourselves. Can we move on? Can we move on, chat? I don't want to spend the whole of today to Wilbur and his One Direction era. What does that mean? Which one am I? Am I Liam? Everyone used to say when I was younger I looked like Liam. I don't look like Liam. Apart from maybe when he does those... Have you seen those selfies that he used to do where he's just like... I like that. That's me. That's me. I'm Liam with the boomer selfies. That's my vibe. You look like an early 2000s band member. I'm a right now band member who is not cutting his hair until the new song is out. That's my whole bit. He looks so sad. I've been shooting mucus out of my face every minute. Every moment of every day, fluff it. What do you want? What do you want from me? Every moment of every day, there is goo. I'm a squelcher. And there is goo in here. Like, you can probably see it. Look. Can you see it? Oh, wait. I'm too cleanly. Harder flu fit. What do you want? Leave me alone, okay? Hold on, let me just sort my hair out now after that. Got a bit all over the place there, didn't it? You're all little parasites. Ooh, let's make fun of Will. We all promised we wouldn't make fun of him. Fuck you, alright? Look, chat, I haven't done a stream in like 20 something days. Do you know why? Because I've been fucking busy as shit, chat. And you know what's coming? In weeks from right this moment where you're sat, in literally countable days from right now, so many cool things for you. I've got a song coming out. I don't know if I'm allowed to tell you. Oh, wait, we'll get to that. I've got a song coming out on the 10th. That's big, right? That's 8 days, chat. 8 days I've got a song coming out. And I'll do a fucking haircut stream. I'll do it. And you guys, is that okay? Will that make you stop making fun of me? Run another poll, mods. Will you stop making fun of me if I do a haircut stream, okay? Okay? Pull your hair, please. It's attached to my head. It's in my scalp. How can I pull my hair out? Do you want me to just rip my hair out in clumps? Jesus. Oh, who's that? Is that Jack Manifold in my chat? In 8 days, I'll have a big freaking boner because I'm so damn excited. Thank you, Jack. I can't wait for you to see it, Jack. For those of you that don't know, Jack Manifold listened to the original cuts of the original music when we were making it because I was in need of a backing vocalist for a little bit. And Jack was my first port of call. And if I'm ever going to do a feature or a backing vocalist, he probably still is my first port of call for Lovejoy. So, to you, Jack, you've been with us since the beginning. Okay, everyone's going to stop making fun. Okay, 66%. Okay, I want to see at least a 30% reduction in people making fun of me now we've done that poll, all right? For those of you who just said yes, you got to stop making fun of my hair, and then when the new song is released, I will cut it off on stream. We will live stream me having, yes, Elodie, no more bullies, only smiles. We will have my hair cut on stream, okay? I'll be like George Not Found. I'll even get like a sexy hairdresser and he'll, was he a sexy hairdresser? I don't remember. I think he was. He was trying to outshone my boy. Listen, chat, we're gonna get a haircut stream and you'll stop bullying me, right? Okay, I'll say the thing I'm not sure if I'm allowed to say. There's a pre-save. I really need to check I'm allowed to say this because there's some attachments to this. Hold on. Am I allowed to talk about this? Because if not, I'm in a pickle. Because I have just said about it. Hold on. Right. Let's go for... yes. How does that sound, guys? Yes. We'll go for yes. Here we go. Chat, there's a pre-save link, and if you pre-save, I think you get some goodies. So I'm gonna spam it in the chat, okay? Click on that. Click on that. Have I done it wrong? Oh god. Imagine I've just sent you all the song. Look, just click that link. I'm spamming it again. And if you pre-save the song, I think you get like little hidden things. All it does is it just means that you're saying, yeah, that's, I want to hear the song when it comes out. That's all we want. On where's the one for Tidal? Bruh, are you listening on Tidal? You want to listen to my new song on Tidal? It'll probably come out on Tidal. I don't know how this shit works. I've never met a Tidal listener though. Doesn't it have like way better sound, Tidal? Isn't that like its meme? Your haircut looks so good. Thank you. Thank you. I've been fucking wait. You know what? I'm gonna put some music on now. That's put me in a good mood. Guys, I've been really shy about this haircut for a while now. And I basically have been desperate to get all of this chopped off for a while. Because it's awful. My hair is too long. It's too moppy. I look like a fucking Ringo Starr. I look like fucking Ringo coming out fucking Twitch TV. Starjoy, I know you. Thank you for the 5. You're like fucking Ringo coming out fucking Twitch TV. And here I am with fucking haircut. Going up to here. Look how fucking high up I go. Look at this. I'm like a fucking... I'm like a... Hanna-Barbera character. The background's falling. No, it's not. It's not falling. There we go. I mean, so today I'm in a field, guys. I'm in an English... In an English wheat field. For you all. The link's broken. Where's the pre-save link? I'm spamming it again. Here, have some blue, thank you for the 5. You guys better all save that link. Look, chat. The minute we can all get over my hair and move on to the more pressing matters. Because I want to talk about what I've been up to. Literally, between the last stream and now, I've done so much stuff that you guys are going to hear all about really soon. And I really want to talk about it. Thank you all so much for the gifted. I've already saved it, don't worry. We'll save it again! Oh, bro. We're moving on. I'm just going to talk, right? Your boy, by the way, Jack's saying that the whole thing I said was a lie. Oh, apparently I never asked Jack to do backing vocals. I must have just thought it. I swear, Jack, we spoke about backing vocals. Like, I remember being in my basement with Joe. And I remember specifically, I didn't play like a sound file for the songs. I played the songs to you, like on a microphone, like open mic. That's, I don't know, I might have just invented that in my head. I'm sorry, chat, I've lied. I didn't know. I didn't even intentionally lie. That was one of those, well, it was one of those accident lies that people do, I hope, otherwise I'm broken. So chat, let me explain what I've been up to. Man's been getting ready for the release of this song. February 10th, I've got my first new song. It's the new era, chat, of Lovejoy. If you're a Lovejoy fan, this is the start of like the next chapter. If you're not a Lovejoy fan, I'd say February 10th is the time to start listening to us for the first time. If you've never listened to Lovejoy, just hold out until February 10th and have a listen. And then you'll be in there from the fucking gate opening. I keep going fucking northern. I've been fucking hanging around northerners all fucking day. I can't do a good accent for it, but I'm getting better, chat. I'm getting better at it. But yeah, in 8 days, chat. 8 days, so about 7, it's about, oh, just over a week. the new song's coming out. If you're a Lovejoy fan, you are going to be like, wow, this is hopefully a jump in quality. Hopefully, stylistically, we're pretty much the same. Sorry if you were hoping for some fucking Arctic Monkeys shit. We start releasing fucking, if you want to walk me to the car, I'll be sure to have a heavy heart. We're not doing any of that. Our style is kind of the same, mainly because I love that style of music we're doing right now still. I still listen to this style of music of like indie rock. So that's what it's on right now still. But the quality, hopefully, it's not anything that I've done. The quality's increased because we have really great people behind us. We found some amazing producers, amazing recording engineers, mixers, mastering. It's like, it sounds like we could be on the radio, which is crazy because we aren't on the radio. We've been on like local radio before, but we've never been on like proper radio. So yeah. By the way, also a couple months ago, I asked you guys to go and listen to the BBC because we were played on like a local BBC station. I asked you guys to go and play it to make everyone think we were cool. You guys did, and all the radio stations were like, man, these guys are cool. Let's get them on the radio. And here we are. So thank you guys. You did great. You did amazing when you did that. So yeah, hopefully we can do some cool stuff. Yeah, that's coming out on February 10th, and I'll do a haircut stream to celebrate, don't worry. What else? So, the other thing, there is a little secret project on the way that some of you have already figured out. A secret little project of which we won't be telling you just yet, but I will tell you it's to do with videos. It's a YouTube project. And I, along with my friend Elodie, have been editing all of it so far. Teehee, she says. I can't tell you anything else. But that's what's happening there. It's got some people you'll love involved, such as a Mr. Charles, a Mr. Watson. We got a Simon in there, and a boob, a straight boob, are involved. Yeah. The pre-save link isn't working. The link is not working for Spotify. Okay, if you go on the Livejoy Twitter account, it should be there. I'll spam it again, though, because some of you got it, so it's got to be working at least half. I just did it and it worked. Try one more time. If it's not, go on Twitter Livejoy. They'll have the pre-save link. So yeah, that's what I've been doing, chat. That's what I've been schnooing, is a bunch of stuff. So yeah, that's and I've been sick, ill, dying this whole time. I've just been the entire time, every shoot day, I've been just like ugh, dying. We've been filming music videos, we've been fucking writing the next stuff. It's been off the wall bonkos, and chat, I'm gonna be honest with you, and I don't do this very often, but I need to get real with you. When I hit go live today, I was like 100% sure this stream would have like 9k viewers. The end of January, early February is a really bad time for being a content creator. That's just how it is. That's how it is. Early January, you can get away with a little bit, but like mid to late January and like early February is like bad. Everyone notices a big downtick. And everyone's being like, what? Why? 9K? 9K sick, bro. I'd be fucking chuffed with 9K. Don't look down on 9K, right? But what I'm saying is that when I went live and I saw I had 25,000 of you on the intro screen, holy fuck. Thank you. Thank you again for sticking around, because I know if there was 9,000 people, just because there'd be like less people doesn't mean you guys were less interested in what I'm doing, because there are people who can't show up to the streams anyway. But for it to be fucking February, early February, and there's still so many of you here, is ridiculous. Thank you so much. I missed you guys too. I'll be streaming more, at least until I have to go and do other things, which will be after February 10th. I've got to go and do more things. But yeah, I want to do a watch party with you guys, watching through all the new videos that I'm working on for YouTube. I can't wait for that to all be done. It's so good and it's so funny. And yeah, Mr. Charles does a lot of Foonies. Is it a wig? No, and leave me alone. Can we see your real hair, Will? Yeah.
Here it is close up.
Good, huh? Yeah? Please say it's good. Is it good? Chimp test, Wilbur. We haven't got... That's at the end of the stream. My eyes are hurting. Ooh, look at... I look so, like, sad and feeble. I look like a little sad, feeble boy. A little Victorian chimney boy. Huh. Who would have thought? Yeah, I look proper, like... I look kind of high. I'm really sick. But it's like, I'm not like dying sick. I'm just like, it's been so long that my body's just exhausted from illness. And like, everyone on TikTok's like, you've got black mold. You've got black mold in your house. I don't have fucking black mold in me fucking gaff. All right, leave me alone. My house is well ventilated and heated. I just am getting sick all the time. I think it's from the pandemic. It's either it's COVID has wrecked my immune system, or being inside during COVID has made me just fucking my body just has forgotten what viruses are and just lets them in, you know? The fucking common cold comes knocking and my body's like, here's a fucking platter for you, sir. Come and make yourself comfortable. Nevi, thank you for the 15. It's mental. Ah, we've hit the goal. Thank you so much. Yeah, it's dumb. I don't like it and I don't want it anymore. Maybe I shall take vitamins. See, the problem is all of the issues with being ill all the time at the moment is that all the solutions are boring shit I don't want to do. Like, oh, you should get your house checked for black mold. No, I can't be bothered. Or it's like, oh, you should take some vitamin supplements. No, I don't want to. This sounds like a conversation between the red guy and the bird from Don't Hug Me, I'm Scared. Maybe you should take some vitamin supplements. No, I don't want to do that. My dad makes vitamin supplements. I'm better at this usually. My nose is clogged, don't judge me. Holly, thank you for the 5. Yeah, I help me. Help me, chat. Just inject me with something. Fun fact, when I fell ill during the lead show, I was offered like a nutrient boost. And I googled it and they have to like fucking, they like lead a wire into you and shit. I was like, no, I'll just go out while sick. And I tweeted, is it sexy and cool if I throw up on stage? And everyone thought I was being all anxious and dramatic when in actuality I was genuinely just vomiting in the fucking Premier Inn hotel bathroom at that moment. He pulled his wig. No, what wig? I'm not wearing a fucking wig. It's my hair, all right? I'm not insecure. Look, you can watch me get it cut off. You'll watch me get it cut off. I'll have to figure out. I don't know how to do a haircut stream. I guess I could bring my hairdresser to my house. But probably the more likely option is I'll just do like an outdoor stream. Oh, it'll be an IRL stream. That'll be fun. I'll do an IRL stream and we'll walk to my hairdresser together. It's so brown. What is it? Why is everyone saying 100? Why is everyone saying 100? Did someone give the 100 subs and I missed it? Holy shit, what? Oh, I've missed it. Oh, who gifted 100 subs? Is it Pot Shut? Oh, it's Potshot. Thank you so much, Potshot, for 100 subs. That is ridiculous. Thank you. That is crazy. I'm very, very thankful. Real hair doesn't move like that. What is real hair supposed to move like, you dumbasses? Bob Ross. Bob these nuts. Got him. I fucked you up there, didn't I? So yeah, chat. Last year I did fuck all. Well, I went on tour. And I released Soft Boy. And I did a few things. But in my opinion, I did fuck all. I like to do more per year. And last year I did very little, in my opinion. I just kind of hung out. And I guess you could call it a break. I guess I had a nice, good needed mental health break last year. But this time, no, I'm going for it. I'm abandoning my mental health. I'm going to go buck wild. There's so much stuff coming out for you guys. It's gonna be like basically, hopefully, if things go well, there's not going to be a week without content from me. And I know, chat, I'm Mr. Big Fucking Promises and No Fucking Delivery. That's the meme you've put me to, despite the fact I make about the same amount of bad promises as other content creators, right? But this time, I'm pretty sure that there will be pretty much like no longer than like 20 days without content from me. I'm pretty sure. Don't get too excited now. I feel bad. I feel like I'm gonna fuck it up. I'm gonna fuck it up and you guys are gonna be sad. But yeah, my calendar this month, this year even, I know exactly where I'm gonna be almost every day till October 1st. Chat, that's never been me. That is new to me. I've never had that. Mr. 11 streams a month. Shut up, dude. I'm sorry. I tried. I did 11 for the first month. I did like 9 for the second, I think. And then I don't remember where I went from there. But it was hard and I wasn't a big fan. Maybe mass streaming isn't for me. Yeah, I know exactly where I'm going to be until October 1st. That is oddly specific, I know, and I've realized I may have given stuff away. That's just what I'm like now. I'm just a little stuff giver awayer. That's just my thing. Oh. It's alright. Thanks, bro. Thank you for saying it's alright as you flew by in chat. Flew by amongst people going, "Wig! Wig!" But yeah, I'm a busy boy, and I hope that this year you'll be like, oh damn, Wilbur's been giving us loads of stuff this year. And if it is, I'm glad, because I feel like you guys have given me so much these past year and a half, and I've done very little this past year and a half. Oh, well, so I ended my dream SMP last year. I wrote an entire fucking story. That was pretty big. That was the biggest thing I did last year. That and Softboy. Softboy and releasing that big written dream SMP document. The finale was smaller only because I've done it for so long it didn't feel like as much of a job. Like, the finale I've been doing for like a year, whilst that short story I wrote, I basically had to format from streams in like under a month, which was crazy. So imagine you've got like a series of like points on a stream thing. I had to write that into a short story in less than a month. That was intense for me. Because I'm not a writer. Utah, yeah, Utah. One day I'll do a Q&A. I did say I'd do a Q&A for that stream. But honestly, chat, I just changed my mind. I felt like the story speaks for itself. And a lot of the questions I had been asked by like friends and other people, just and like questions I've seen people asking on like the internet, people just hadn't watched the run-up streams, you know? So it's like, why I'd be answering questions like, why did you only say goodbye to Tommy? Even though I did like 8 streams leading up where I said goodbye to everyone. Anyway, Potshirt with 100 gifted. Thank you so much. You definitely watched all the streams, didn't you, Potshirt? You watched all of the little, Dream SMP streams. You knew all about it. Someone said squelch. Is that my nose? I'm sorry. Let me blow my nose. Should I blow it on camera? Do you guys want to see this? Look away now if you don't like mucus flying out of someone's face. Ugh. That was a good one. Who wants to look inside my nose? Am I giving you the ick? Is this working? Oh, let me just Let me just sort my hair out.
There we go. There we go.
I look a bit like a 1980s superhero. Nose cam. Someone in my chat just went, all clean now. Oh.
All clean now. Who's got a clean nose? Is it you? All clean now.
Fuck off. Creepy, creepy fuck. Get out of my chat. Don't actually get out of my chat. It was funny. I was giggling. You made me giggle, champ.
All clean. Nice clean nostrils. Fit for strolling in and out. Swinging a cane, whistling a tune, the good old days.
Show us your forehead. Oh, my hairline. Oh, I'm losing my hair, chat. Imagine this is someone's first stream. Imagine someone does not know who the fuck I am and they're like, oh, who's this guy in the just chatting category and clicks? Who? I wonder, there's someone, there's got to be at least one person in chat right now who has never seen a Wilbur Soot stream and does not know who the fuck I am, who has just joined and is just like, I don't know what the fuck is going on and I'm never watching this man again. There is someone here that is the case of. Someone in chat who's a first-time chatter just said me. Another one said, hi, dude. Wait, how many of you are there? Me? These are all people who've never spoken in my chat before. First stream, know who you are, though. Okay, that's fine. B-Impact says, hi. Tiny Furble that says, that's me right now. So, go away. This isn't normal. Go away. Never come back. Well... Hi, if you don't know who I am, welcome aboard. This feels like my SMP Live days, where I'd have thicker hair and introducing myself to people. Hey guys, my name's Wilbur. I do Minecraft streaming. I like the slime block, lapis lazuli. Lapis lazuli. Lapis lazuli. Just, you guys wonder why I don't stream like every day like fucking Tubbo. So what is Tubbo doing? What does this boy do?
Really loud, so we can't put it near residential. So it'll need to be in like a commercial area. Maybe.
Is this what you do?
Depot usually is a bit outside of the center. Yeah, no, that's what I was thinking. I want to know what I want to do with this, because these tram tracks can't just lead to dead ends. This one has a really nice...
Like, how does he have so much energy, chat?
I kind of want to build the same on the other side here.
How does he have so much fucking energy? He's just going. Every day. He's a champion. I'm not making fun of him, chat. I'm impressed. I wish I could do that. I wish I could do the Tubbo moment.
What happened here?
What happened here, Tubbo?
What happened to you?
What happened to me?
Why are you shaped like that?
Shut up, Tubbo. Don't. He was talking about City Skylines. He wasn't talking about me. Chat, that wasn't about me. That was about City Skylines. He wasn't asking why I'm... Oh. Oh, God. I'm closing Tubbo's stream. Oh, bro. Kind of suits me. I feel like I should keep this haircut. Don't you think? Maybe I don't get a haircut ever. Ugh. This is how I stay. Chat, let's just talk. Ask me questions and I'll give you answers. Do you want to see my Tamagotchi? It's missing two lines because I dropped him in a pint of water and he broke, but I unscrewed it and fixed it. Here he is. See, it's kind of hard to see him. Hold on. There we go. You see him? He's in child's phase right now. He's the son. He's the first boy I've had in a while. He's my 10th generation Tamagotchi. I have kept 10 Tamagotchis alive in a row without any dying. And proof, let me give you proof that he's number 10. Come on. There you go. Generation 10. He's the first boy I've had in a while. I had my boy Pumbo. He was the legend Pumbo. He was my favorite Tamagotchi. And then I had Crumb afterwards. She was sick. Crumb was a sick Tamagotchi. Followed by her son, Jubio, who was great. By the way, most of my Tamagotchis are crossbred too. I've basically handed out Tamagotchis to everyone in Brighton. Everyone in the city I live has a Tamagotchi now. And it's become a thing that they've started, like, organizing Tamagotchi, like, fuck parties without me. Like, there are people in Brighton who have my Tamagotchi. I've loaned it to them. So it's the rule is they can keep the Tamagotchi till it dies. Then it has to come back to me. But there are people in Brighton organizing Tamagotchi fuck parties that I'm not invited to. There are people with Tamagotchi fuck... Let me reiterate this for you. Right? I'm a man in his mid-20s who is being purposefully uninvited from Tamagotchi fuck parties. Chat, these are parties where people breed their Tamagotchis together. They are not fucking each other. The Tamagotchis are fucking each other, right? Now, the problem is, I've had so many girls in a row, and everyone else has had so many girls, that they don't need more girls, so I'm uninvited. Chat? But either way, I've still done well, and I've still been breeding with different Tamagotchis every time. And Crumb bred with a Chegg, I think, and had a young gentleman named Jubio. Jubio was a Mimichi, who was my favorite Tamagotchi. Jubio wasn't my favorite Tamagotchi, but he was my favorite type. He was a Mimichi, which is my favorite. And then Jubio gave birth to Nauni, who was ass. Nauni was fucking dreadful Tamagotchi. And then Nauni gave birth to Taxes, who was also a dreadful Tamagotchi. And then Taxes gave birth to Fraud, who was pretty bad. And then Fraud gave birth to this Tamagotchi that I've got right now, called Motorway Jesus. This Tamagotchi's name is Motorway Jesus. Chat, do you think I'm fucking bluffing? Do you think I'm making this up? Do you think I just walked in here, I waltzed in here and made something up about Tamagotchi fuck parties? That's not something I can do, chat. I wish I could invent Tamagotchi fuck parties. But alas, my dear children, I cannot. Here is the Tamagotchi family tree. Here is the Tamagotchi family tree. And to prove I'm not lying, there's Taxes and Fraud, and there's Motorway Jesus. He's not got a picture yet because he's not grown up. And to prove I'm not bluffing, before Taxes comes Nauni. And before Nauni comes Jubio. And before Jubio comes Crumb. Oh, there's Crumb over there. Quip was Matt. And before Crumb comes Pumbo. I'm not fucking lying. They are having Tamagotchi fuck parties. Look at this shit. Look at this. I'm not involved in that. That's just a bunch of breeding. I didn't do that. Man. Fucking name their Tamagotchi. That one I showed on the screen just then was a Tamagotchi named Kanye. That was an accident that I let slide for that person. They accidentally named their Tamagotchi Kanye, to which all of us were appalled. Turns out they were just seeing if Kanye would fit and accidentally accept. So now we're doomed to permanently have a Tamagotchi called fucking Kanye on the family tree. Sigh. Will, are you okay? No, I'm not. I'm struggling to keep afloat just generally in life. Who called their Tamagotchi Kanye? You will have to ask them yourself. I am not throwing someone under the bus like that. Imagine you shit yourself at work, right? And you tell someone in private, like, hey man, I made a fucking mistake. I shat myself. I need to go home and change. And you're like, oh yeah, that's cool. Like, no worries, I'm not gonna judge you. And you go on the fucking intercom and go, ladies, oh, fucking, my thing's broken, but ladies and gentlemen, Meredith has shit themselves. I repeat, Meredith has shit themselves in the store. It was Bilzo. Bilzo does not own a Tamagotchi anymore, chat. Bilzo does not own a Tamagotchi. I loaned it to him, right? And he was sick. Bilzo was the best Tama owner I've ever had, and he was amazing. And he vibed with me, and I vibed with him. And I gave him a Tamagotchi to look after, chat, and he cared for it. And it even bred with mine, with my first generation, Alex Turner. It bred with Alex Turner, and it had a baby. Bilzo then kills one of its babies. So I say, okay, well, the rule is when it dies, you've got to give it back to me. And Bilzo's like, no, please give me another chance. So I say, okay, give him another chance. He immediately kills the next one. He says, give me another chance. I go, okay. I give him another chance. This one doesn't even make it. You know the one, if you're a Bilzo watcher, you know the one he put on that little chair on stream? That's the one I'm talking about now. That's his third attempt. He hits reset, he sets it up, it dies again immediately. I say, Bilzo, can I have my Tamagotchi back, please? He goes, yep. He gives it back 2 months later. Fucking Bilzo, man. Bilzo is blacklisted. He's a blacklisted Tamagotchi owner. Maybe he can have his redemption one day, but not soon. He'd go fuck himself, honestly. Yeah. Yeah. But anyway, on better news, I've kept mine going for 10 generations. So that's about 4 months. 4 months of Tamacare. Dude, I'll tell you what, this haircut's giving me a headache. This haircut's really tight, if you know what I mean. And it's giving me a really big headache right now. Does James have one? Yes, he does. He's got Mocha, first generation. Ask me anyone in Brighton, and I'll tell you if they have one or not. And that most likely they've been given one and then have either failed or still have it. Go on, give me a name of someone. Just shave it. I will. Name someone. Tommy had one. He killed it pretty immediately. He grew it to an adult because he learned that if you put it on pause, you don't need to look after it. So he just put it on pause all day. He would unpause it while watching a film or something and then put it on pause again. Just constantly. Never stopped. And then eventually one day he wasn't able to put it on pause and it died because he had no fucking clue how to do it. So yeah, no. Tommy does not have a Tamagotchi anymore. I took it off him. At least he gave it back promptly though. Rambu. I've offered Rambu quite a few times, but he's basically been pretty indifferent. I think he does want one, but like he's scared he'll kill it, not understanding that I will just take it off him if he does. Tubbo. Tubbo does not live in Brighton. Quackity literally lives on the other side of the world. Hello. Did I just hello you? I'm sorry. It's people in Brighton. Nikki does not. Nikki does not have a Tamagotchi. She isn't on the waiting list. What the fuck was that? She's not on the waiting list either. She's very welcome to join though. I haven't spoken to her about it. Because James Marriott does. Scott's Major does not. Rue does. Rue is a very good carer. Rue is on generation 6 of her Tamagotchi and she's great at it. She does amazing. I'm all in favor of Rue. Aimsy does not. I've actually only ever met Aimsy once. Where she came to my flat. And they were very nice. Filza does not live in Brighton, but I would be willing to give him a Tamagotchi because I will be seeing him a lot as of the coming next few years. Jack Manifold? Yes. Jack Manifold does not. He's not on the waiting list either. Jack, if you want to get on the waiting list, just ask me. Aria does, yeah. She's also very good carer. She's on generation 4. Rihanna does, yes. Shelby in my chat, but I'm the greatest Tamagotchi carer. Shelby's also on generation 10. Shubble is a long time Tama keeper on generation 10. So Ash hates them, I think. Well, okay, no, I have to stand up for Ash. Okay, let's stop saying names, chat. We're done now. Ash is not a very good Tamagotchi carer. He used to have one and he killed it and he doesn't care about them anymore. However, he's the biggest, like, advocate for my Tamagotchi. We were going to record in another city, and we were in the car, and literally upon getting in the car, I realized I left my Tamagotchi at home. And I was fucking messed up, because that Tamagotchi was gonna die if I didn't get it, and because I'd be gone for like 10 hours, and that Tamagotchi was in a weak state. I needed to be caring for it. And Ash led the fucking charge. He was like, turn the car around, we're saving that fucking Tamagotchi. He saved Nauni. Albeit I wanted Nauni dead, but at the same time, I'm glad Nauni didn't die. Ash is good. He doesn't have his own Tamagotchi, but he cares for the lives of others, and that's all we can ask for. Have you all pre-saved the new song, by the way? Have you all pre-saved it? Get to spamming, mods. Show them the fucking pre-save link. Yes, good. Do you want to know why I've got a pre-save? I'll be transparent with you. So the pre-save, one, I just think it's really good for making sure you guys don't miss out, and we can offer you little secrets and surprises if you're on the pre-save. But the second reason is, chat, we're fucking so new in this industry. The music industry, and I'll be honest with you, music industry looks at us with fear a little bit, because we've come out of nowhere. It's common for bands to come out of nowhere, but like, we've come out of a place where we've had, like, we don't know anyone in the industry. We don't have any like no one, none of our like parents understand like the music industry or anything. We've all come from a background of like, I'm the first person in my family to play musical instruments, apart from my grandpa, who passed away sadly when I was quite young. I'm the first one in the family to play a musical instrument. So we've come out of physical just nothing, right? But we've been flanked by the fucking best fans, the best fucking fans in the world, who you guys have been fucking just repping us hard, right? It doesn't work well. Well, I can't go on Twitter live joy and that should do it. But yeah, we've been flanked by the most fucking diehard, most just follow us to the ends of the earth fans in the world. And the music industry is a bit shaken up by it. They still don't know what to think of us, I feel like. And like, you know, we're at that stage now where it's like, we don't know what to do with our quote unquote power. Because it feels like we're at that stage now where we can start asking for things. And I've been making criteria from the get-go for what I want for accessibility at shows and things. But like, I'm at the stage now where I feel like I want to start supporting other people who do not have ins in the music industry or whatever, and see what I can do. Ash is already doing this, and he's doing it amazingly. I know I've just been singing Ash's praises all day, but Ash has just been like, all of our support acts are like picked by Ash, partially, I'm pretty sure. And he purposefully goes out of his way to support new acts who are just doing really cool stuff. But the reason I want you guys to pre-save as well is because those numbers are used by people in the industry. They look at pre-save numbers, and if they see the pre-save numbers are high, they may push the song more, which is great for me, but also it's great for just fucking pushing into this industry even further. And I want to make it worth its time. I know it's pretty selfish reasons I want the pre-saves, but also I want to be able to give back to you, and I want to know who's interested, you know, because I can't just keep doing streams talking about the song, because there's people here who want to watch GeoGuessr and stuff, you know. Basically, what I'm trying to say is I'm grateful, and I'm not very good with expressing gratitude, because I never have been. Anyone else like this? There's probably something undiagnosed there, but I've never been good at expressing gratitude, or like, you know, I've never been good at telling people, you know, I'm thank you for this, and this specifically I'm grateful for. But I'm very grateful for everything you guys have done, and if I was a better wordsmith, I'm sure I would tell you in a much more eloquent way. So please accept thank you as the best. Imagine I've said something really, really eloquent and artistic and poetic. Let's do the human fucking human thing, human benchmark. And ignore my headache that is growing from this haircut. Human benchmark time. Right. Is it GeoGuessr? It's GeoGuessr, right? Yes, okay, so let's start off with reaction time. So chat, for those of you who don't know, this is a website that measures how good you are as a person, or not how good, but like how, where your foundation, where your benchmark is, where you're starting, you know, to see if you're getting better or getting worse, or you know, it's just a bunch of mental and physical tests that you can do on your computer to find out where you sit. And I've been doing it every stream, and I'm gonna do it now. So here's, let's do reaction time first. This one, all I have to do is click when it turns green. Okay. Nice, 174, that puts us there. That's pretty good, right? Like just like there, that's good. Okay, let's put that in. 174, that is our second best out of three, so probably not that good. Memory, sequence memory. Boom. Boom, boom. Yeah. It's riveting gameplay. Okay. Maybe this hair is making me smarter. Got a good seed. Okay. Okay. This hair's giving me superpowers. It's all about confidence, chat. Ah, 13. That is my worst. Okay, that's my worst. What do we think, chat? How was that? Okay, it's just saying, okay, fuck you. Stop making fun of me. Why are you making fun of me? Are we, fuck aim trainer. Number memory. 2. 94. 276. Easy. Do that with my eyes closed. 48, 39. That's a really good one. That's just plus 11 to each number. No, minus, whatever. 422-03. Easy. 258-040. Good. 545-9476. 545-9476. Okay, good. 994-791-62. 929-620-180. 211-634-9307. 211-63-49. 211-63-49. Oh, fuck, I don't know. Level 10. That's better than my first time. Verbal memory. Okay. Let's go. Garter. That's new. Assertions. Non-occurrence. Rhymia. Purulences. Abroad. Non-occurrence. Purulences. Abash. Defrosters. Gartered. Infests. Cauterize. Defrosters. Fleeter. Alginates. Proliferation. Hard-heartedness. Alginates. Atom. Figures. Incipiencies. Shredders.
What about my shredder?
Hard-heartedness. Rashness. Metrify. Salinese. Chivalry. Purulences. Fleeter. Alginates. Defrosters. Buddhism. Non-occurrence. Buddhism. Kinkina. Probiscides. Outspokenness. Abroad. Abash. Buddhism. Cauterize. Consume. Kinkina. Gartered. Tapster. Cossack. Proliferation. Purulences. Cossack. Cauterize. Salvages. Incipiencies. Chanting. Aphis. Assertions. Diligently. Solidly. Chivalry.
Shredders.
Valetudinarianism. Valetudinarianism. Proliferation. Aphis. Infests. Generalized.
Shredders.
Hunches. Impings. Sudsiest. Sudsiest. Finalities. Abash. Liveryman. Rondo. Figures. Hunches. Consume. Queer. Gartered. Showiness. Potatoes. Reconsolidated. Cellaring. Hunches. Fleeter. Ah, shit. I thought we'd seen Fleeter. I thought we hadn't seen Fleeter. 82. Wow. There is a gap between these, chat. There's everyone with the fucking chat. Don't fucking be weird. 99, 29, 82. Cool. Okay. Chimp test. If we can be real about that word for a second, I've always never understood where a cis straight man sits with it, because I've been told by people in the LGBT community that it's okay to refer to the blanket as that, but I don't know if it's my place to say it, you know. I need to get educated if that's actually able to like refer to that word in that way, or because I did stop for a second. I was like, is this bad? Am I allowed to say it? I don't really know, so that's something I will have to ask more about. It's how you say it. That's what I thought. That's what I always thought too, but it always feels weird because it was a word used as a slur, you know. Whilst there are plenty of words that weren't used as a slur that I still feel weird saying, such as the other phrase for Native American, as far as I'm aware, as in like the word Indian being used for the word Native American. I that was never used as a slur to my knowledge. It might have been against my knowledge, but I'd still feel weird using it, and I'm pretty sure you shouldn't use it. So it's a really weird area. I'll have to learn more about. But if you guys say it's fine, then I can trust you guys pretty well usually. This one I hate. I suck at this one, bro. I'm really bad at this. 1, 2, 3. Okay. This is a pretty good seed. Easy. 1, 2, 3. Okay, I said it was a good seed. This is now hard. 1, 2, 3. Fuck! 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 1, 2, 3. What? That was 7. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, good. We got past 9. That was all I wanted. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Easy. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Ah! 11. One less than I did every other time. Visual memory, sure. Okay, good. Bam, bam, bam. Nice. Nice. Good. Okay. 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 Penis. Okay. Fuck. Oh, that one was, the last one was way easier. Fuck. Okay, that one's easy. Come on. Okay. Woo! Okay, that was lucky. Fuck. 11. That's the same as last time. No change. Typing. Okay. Whales are not fish, and they must regularly get back to the surface to breathe. There are many types of whales, each with their own characteristics, you fuck, and vastly different sizes. The most famous by far is the blue whale, the largest animal to have ever lived on this planet. Longer than a tennis court, it also holds the record for the most powerful call in the animal kingdom, which is louder than a jet engine. 87. Hey, that's not too bad. I always feel like a Karen. Whales are the largest animals in our ecosystem. Well, chat, there we are. That's my, these are my stats for the past three streams. Pretty good. I'm glad I'm back on it with the verbal memory. Listen, chat, I've got to go. I'm going to go take a fucking medicine. But it's been fun. It's been really good. Remember to pre-save the song. Listen to the song coming out on February 10th. And for those of you that stayed to the end, I got a little surprise for you. That's not the surprise. The surprise is your boy's going to be dropping the song in the background of a random person's stream. So if you catch me on someone's stream, make sure you're looking out, because I might be dropping the entirety of Call Me What You Like on someone's stream. All right. Goodbye. It's been fun. You've been great. Have a nice day. Go say hi to Tubbo. I wonder if he's going to build more roads. I'm gonna wait here while we say goodbye to Tubbo. I mean, while we say hi to Tubbo. I'm gonna be hanging out with Tubbo, I think, so go